Hello everyone, my name is Swapnil. I'm the Deputy Commissioner of East Garo Hills in Meghalaya. We have a small district here with a population of around 4 lakhs and it's mostly hilly terrain with a lot of streams and a big river called Simsang. And we have a lot of potential to convert this district into, you know, a self-sufficient district in terms of agriculture produce, in terms of horticulture produce, in terms of other necessary food items. One of the examples I want to mention is that there are some paddy cultivators here, and as a result, there are some rice mills. And one residential area in the district headquarters had a person running this mill. And he was facing a lot of problem in terms of recurring cost of diesel. And then the noise pollution in the locality was also creating another hindrance with the idea of a solar powered, rice mill. And now he'll be able to continue his operations, help the people, and then, without creating any issues of noise pollution. So that's a brilliant solution in that regard. Another aspect of what we plan to work is to create resilient houses in rural areas. So under this Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, there are a lot of beneficiaries which will be getting the scheme in this coming year. So we have identified and we have decided that on 100 houses and try to create a new model of sort of a model PMAY house, which will have solar and rainwater. But apart from that, it will also be weather resilient. Because as you see, every year these areas being hilly and very open, there are a lot of cyclones and hailstorms. So every year there's a lot of expenditure on relief when these kachcha houses which people live in, they get just blown away and demolished with the strong winds. And every year there's a lot of expenditure from the government side also. So once they have these pakka houses, resilient houses, that will save a lot of government revenue, government money, which is being sent as relief. And rural housing should be looked into that it should be weather resilient so that the recurring expenditure is cut down to the minimum. And then those funds can be reallocated to the other development aspects pertaining to the rural development. Because of this corona scenario, I think this kind of chaos has given us a brilliant opportunity where people are thinking that we need to be self-sufficient. We need not depend on any outside other state, because now in the last 2-3 months when the supply lines were cut off, I think people have realized this. And we have used this opportunity to motivate people to go ahead and, in terms of all kinds of production in the district, we can and we should, enhance our capabilities, enhance the production here and make this district self-sufficient. Once that is done, we can look into, sending our produce out. So this corona situation has in fact given us that opportunity to make our pitch louder. And I think it has worked, and people are now realizing that, and we look forward to make this district self-sufficient.